have been known. Everything is perfect. Everything just fine. We're keeping everything moving while the sun is shining.
Built around a strong work ethic, immense skill, and a passion for the game, the Colorado College men's Division I hockey team has had a myriad of success throughout the program's 73-year history. In the team's 20 NCAA tournament appearances, the Tigers have reached the renowned Frozen Four 10 times and have won the national championship twice. The program has also fostered significant individual achievement. 30 former Tigers have gone to play in the NHL, two of which also received the NCAA's Most Valuable Player trophy. Despite this distinguished history, the Tigers currently find themselves struggling amidst a somewhat less successful season.
It's definitely not the start that anyone envisioned or hoped for. So, you know, I just got to kind of work through it, work through your problems and, you know, stay positive, come to the rink every day willing to get better and willing to do the little things to get better.
Part of the Tigers' issues this season stem from the fact that they are playing in a new conference, leaving the WCHA for the arguably much more competitive NCHC. Moreover, the team graduated several valuable seniors, including Rylan Schwartz and Scott Winkler. While the loss of Schwartz and his NCAA leading 53 points was undoubtedly significant, Winkler's loss was even more challenging from an emotional standpoint. Winkler tragically passed away not even a month after graduation, leaving family, friends, and teammates in shock. With heavy hearts entering the season, the team struggled off to a 1-10-2 start.
We had a tough start to the season, but I mean, that's gonna happen. All you can do is really work hard and try not to listen too much to the critics and kind of just play your own game. It's gonna happen to teams, ups and downs, and I'm sure it's just as easy to win 10 games as it is to lose 10 games, so.
Just as player Mike Morin said, the Tigers dug deep and found some spark, taking 4 of the possible 6 points from the conference-leading University of Nebraska-Omaha Mavericks.
So we kind of took it to them in a little bit in their offensive zone on our forecheck, which was huge, and we kind of tired out their defensemen and made a 200-foot game.
After a more promising weekend, the Tigers have 1 week to prepare for a challenging set of road games against the nationally ranked number 15 Wisconsin Badgers. The Badgers are unbeaten at home this season, making the Tigers' preparation for the games that much more difficult and important.
Anything specific you're working on to prepare for the Wisconsin game coming up?
Probably a little bit more scoring. This weekend we started to score a little bit more, which is nice. So just keep putting the puck in the net and see where it goes.
Okay, it's a loud building here. We want to hear you come in and talk to the defensemen. In our layers, we want D, forward, D. Okay? And that first core has got to take charge and be yelling, I'm back, I'm back, I got it.
We came off a better weekend last weekend and just try to carry that over and use that momentum.
Part of this preparation also included adjusting to Wisconsin's narrower ice surface in the Kohl Center. Luckily, the U.S. Olympic training site adjacent to the World Arena is similar in dimensions. The players suit up in their World Arena locker room, walk over to the rink next door, and practice begins.
You got it.
We
we're not flying by and leaving that area as much as before. There's still room for improvement, though. Again, pull the shoe, stop, head on swivel. The other thing is this.
Yeah, they're a good team. They've been beat. They can be beat, just like anybody in our conference, like anybody in college hockey. So.
Let's go, boys.
The practice is grueling as players struggle to catch their breath in between the drills. However, despite the intensity on the ice, the team manages to find time for some fun, reminding us that hockey is, after all, just a game.
Who do you think the cutest guy on our team is, if you could say?
Peter Stojkovic.
Peter Stojkovic, I think so too. What's your favorite Christmas cookie?
Gingerbread. Every time.
Who would you say the cutest guy on our team is?
Not Goose.
Not Goose. I think it might be Morin.
No. Morin's got Dawson flow.
Oh.
Might be Stikes, but
You're ugly, Thorny.
Right now is the best moment you ever know. Everything is perfect.
2 days later, the players rise early and drive to the World Arena. From there, they will be bused to Denver, where their morning flight departs for Wisconsin. The gear is packed, secured underneath the bus, and the team begins the trip up I-25, anxious for the upcoming hockey. The first of the two games is a challenge for the Tigers. Alexander Krushelnitsky accounts for the sole goal in the 4-1 loss. The Tigers squander 2 5-on-3 power play advantages in the third period, unable to beat Wisconsin goalie Joel Rumpel. Looking to rebound from the tough previous night, the Tigers come out with all cylinders firing on Saturday, taking a 2-0 lead into the first intermission. However, the Badgers come blazing back, stunning the Tigers with 3 goals in the course of 5 minutes. Despite the Tigers' relentless pressure on the Wisconsin defense, they still can't find the net. With 1 minute and 18 seconds left to go in the game, Coach Scott Owens pulls his goalie in order to send an extra skater onto the ice. Merely seconds later, and against all odds, the Tigers tie the game from a rebound by Archie Skalbeck. While the Badgers would eventually win the game in overtime off a freak goal from behind the Tigers' goal line, the game cannot be entirely looked at as a failure. The team's ability to stay focused on the game despite surrendering 3 quick goals speaks wonders about the Tigers' preparation, endurance, and resiliency. With plenty of season to go, the Tigers will continue to focus on fundamentals, build team chemistry, and learn how to channel their talent and passion for the game into success on the ice.
But the fire's warm and we're all